You have a brokerage account. Now what? Once you have your brokerage account set up and you have some money in there, your money's just sitting there as cash in your account. You want to get your money working for you and growing for you, right? But your brokerage account isn't an investment. It's just a type of account, like a checking account or a savings account is a type of account. So the next step is to actually invest in something inside your brokerage account. But how exactly do you do that? And what should you invest in? In this video, I'll give you a step-by-step demo, and we'll talk about what to invest in to make passive income. Because even though this works as a standalone video, it's also video number 5 in my How to Make Passive Income e-course, which you can check out for fun and for free right here on YouTube. If you want to learn how to make passive income, and you haven't seen the first 4 videos, I highly recommend you go back after this and watch any that you might have missed. Because through this course, I'll walk you through making passive income step by step. You want to make sure that you're building a strong financial foundation, right? So it's really important to master the fundamentals before moving on to some of the ninja strategies I'll be sharing later in this course, including how to make passive income with no money down. So I'll post the link in the description in case you missed any of the earlier videos, or you can search Penelope Jane Smith on YouTube and look for that playlist on my channel. Okay, let's talk about what to invest in to make passive income. Then I'll show you a step-by-step demo of how to do that in your brokerage account. And if you find this useful, please let me know by tapping the like button on this video. Quick disclaimer, I'm not a financial planner and I don't sell financial products or give financial advice. So I'm not gonna tell you what to buy. Also, investing is a big topic and it can get super complicated. So there's no way I can teach you everything I know about investing in this short video, but I can share a strategy with you. One popular investment strategy is to just buy and hold index funds. And I'll share exactly what that means and how it works in just a sec. To be fully transparent, this isn't my absolute favorite strategy in the world, but what I do really like about it, and the reason I bring it up here, is it's easy and you can put it on autopilot. And that makes it a great place to start, because if you're anything like most of the financial coaching clients I work with, you're busy. And if it takes too much time to implement your investment strategy, or if it's too complicated and confusing, it's not gonna happen, right? So what does it mean to buy and hold index funds? And why might you want to consider doing that as the foundational layer of your investing? Well, a stock market index is a measurement of a section of the market, like a basket of a bunch of stocks. Imagine you have a big basket full of Easter eggs, and each Easter egg is a different stock. Tesla, Google, Amazon, Starbucks, they're all together in this big basket. When you invest in a fund that tracks that index, you own a little piece of that whole basket. So you own a little tiny bit of everything in there. If you're not familiar with index funds, here's how they work. You can't invest in an index itself, but there are funds that pool investors' money together to do their best to mirror or mimic the index. They buy the stocks that are listed on that index, so the fund is going to do pretty much what the index does. My favorite stock market index is the S&P 500. The S&P stands for Standard & Poor's, which is the name of the company that came up with it. And the S&P 500 is basically a list of the top 500 stocks in the United States. But this applies to you no matter where in the world you live. Why is this my favorite? Well, it's really hard to beat the performance of the S&P 500 consistently over a long period of time. According to Forbes, the majority of actively managed funds don't beat the S&P 500. These are funds that are managed by trained professionals who eat, sleep, and breathe this stuff, whose sole goal is to beat the S&P 500, and they still can't do it. If you're paying 1-3% in fees, and that fund can't even beat the S&P 500, wouldn't you be better off just investing in an S&P 500 index fund that'll grow your money faster, practically for free? So I like to use the S&P 500 as a benchmark for my investing, which means that's what I'm trying to beat, and if I can't beat it, why be out of it? If you can't beat them, join them, right? The way I look at it, when you're investing in an S&P 500 index fund, it's like you're buying the whole market. So your risk of losing money is pretty low in the long term. One of the biggest things that stops people from investing, or that keeps them in only the most conservative investments that hardly do anything, is they're afraid of losing money. But there's a difference between volatility and risk. Roller coasters go up and down. That's the volatility part. But as long as you stay on until the end of the ride, the risk of getting hurt is minimal. So this chart shows you how even though the stock market is volatile, it goes up and down all the time, the longer you leave your money in the market, the less chance there is that you'll lose money, and the greater the chance that your money will grow. Historically, if you left your money in for a 5-year period, nearly 87% of the time, it would have gone up. 10 years, over 94% of the time. 20 years, 100% of the time. Now, this isn't the case with single stocks. Even companies that were considered totally stable and conservative have gone out of business completely. But for you to lose all your money when you're investing in an S&P 500 index fund would mean a collapse of the entire financial system, basically. If you honestly think that's going to happen, then you should invest in setting yourself up to live off the grid, right? Otherwise, this strategy might work for you. What I like best about this is you can set it and forget it. It really is quite passive. What most people don't know about passive income is that there are varying degrees of passive. Some income streams are more passive than others. For example, you can receive passive income from rental real estate, right? But real estate investing comes with a much higher hassle factor than just buying an S&P 500 index fund, which takes the click of a button and you're done. And then you can have your money working hard for you and growing for you, getting the mind-blowing power of compound interest on your side, and outperforming most actively managed funds with very little risk of losing money in the long term. The biggest downside to this strategy is the stock market is volatile, and there will be periods of time where the market is down, sometimes 50, 60%, and it can take years to recover and move higher again. So you have to commit to breathe through the downturns and not panic sell when things are getting scary, and you gotta focus on the long term. But overall, I still think it can be a great place to start. Now, how do you make passive income from index funds? One passive income misconception is that the passive income has to come to you as a regular check in the mail or direct deposit into your account. How this actually works in the real world is that in your wealth building journey, there is a growth stage and an income stage. In the growth stage, you're building your assets and reinvesting the dividends and reinvesting the profits until your investment portfolio is big enough that you can start pulling money off of it to live on in the income stage. You're growing and nurturing the golden goose until it's big enough that it can lay enough golden eggs for you to live off of. Then the income stage is when you officially retire or become financially free and start living off the golden eggs. In video number 2 of this course, I shared how to figure out your magic number for how big of a golden goose you need in order to be able to live off the golden eggs. If you've already hit your magic number, then you're gonna focus on investing for income. If you're using the 4% rule that I shared in video number 2, you would sell off 4% of your investments, and that would be your passive income for the year. You can set it up to do that all in one big chunk, or sell off a bit every quarter or every month. If you haven't hit your magic number yet, then you're going to be investing for growth and possibly even creating new passive income streams to fill in the gaps for what you need. Now, let's talk about how to invest inside your brokerage account. You can't invest in an index like the S&P 500 directly, but there are a lot of funds that are designed to track or mimic the S&P 500. So you can call up wherever you have your brokerage account and ask, what S&P 500 index tracking funds do you have available? And they'll give you some combinations of letters. These are called ticker symbols. It's like the stock or fund's nickname. You know how airports have those 3-letter nicknames, like San Francisco is SFO and Los Angeles is LAX? Well, stocks and funds have nicknames like that. For example, if you have an account with Vanguard, they'll probably tell you to check out VOO or VFINX. Now, how do you actually buy an index fund or any other type of investment inside of your investment account. I'll walk you step by step through this now. So here's how you buy something. I'm gonna go to tdameritrade.com since that's where I have my brokerage account. I actually created a public account so I can demo this for you. I click log in and enter my name and password to log in. And then when I log into TD Ameritrade, I see this screen. To buy an index fund or any mutual fund or ETF or stock, I go to the trade tab and then click on stocks and ETFs. Under action, it already says buy, so I'll leave it like that. Under quantity, I put in the number of shares I want to buy. And under symbol, I put in the ticker symbol of the stock or other asset I want to buy. Under order type, I select market. I'm doing this while the stock market is open, and under time and force, it already says day, so I'm just gonna leave it like that, scroll down and click review order, and then click place order. I'm buying this to show you how to do it, but don't buy this particular fund just because I'm using it in this demo, okay? This isn't financial advice. This isn't a stock pick or recommendation. This is just a demo of the logistics of how to buy something inside of your investment account. So many people get stopped by the tech part. I thought it would be helpful to show you step by step how you can do this. Now, investing in index funds like this can be a great place to start in laying a firm foundation for your wealth building. And then you can start adding in more exciting assets if you want to, like what you'll discover in our next video on how to make passive income with cryptocurrency, even if you're not tech savvy and without subjecting yourself to the wild price swings that you typically find in the crypto world. I'll see you there.